Hey, it's Clay, and this will be a video chart on Bitcoin. We will take a look at the 4-hour time frame. Real quick, what do I mean by 4-hour in case maybe you're new to charts? Instead of each one of these candlesticks, as they're called, representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you would normally see, each one represents 4 hours. So while this here may look like a couple of months worth of time, it's actually just the past several days broken down into 4-hour time slices. I like to do this time frame. I think it's a good job of telling the quote-unquote story of the price, and then makes mapping outward levels of support and resistance a bit easier to see. Friendly reminder, Bitcoin is open 24/7. So if you're watching this video 20 hours after I upload it, then yeah, the chart's gonna look a little bit different for you. But my goal here from the presentation standpoint is to keep this video relevant for as long as possible. So I'm gonna do that by just talking about some general levels and then walking you through some questions. And based on how you answer those questions, that'll dictate the current status of the chart. So the very first question you need to ask yourself is in regards to this purple line right there, which on my chart denotes the very famous 50 period moving average. And the value of that, give or take, is right around 8,800. So question number one when you're watching, listen, let's just go with that, 20 hour number. Let's just say you're watching this 20 hours from now. So ask yourself, where's the price at relative to 8,800? If you're answering the question that the price is up above that level, then that means that the overall chart is still perfectly fine. This is, the moving average and it's trending upwards. So as long as the price is up above, a line that is trending higher and higher, then that's what you want to see. That is a good sign of health. With that being said, if you happen to be answering the question, well, actually, Clay, the price is down below 8,800, not the end of the world, but the next immediate question you would want to ask yourself is, okay, well, where is the price at relative to 8,300? Now, if somehow you're answering the question that the price is down below 8,300, at that point, the landscape of the chart has shifted quite a bit, and that would imply that the bears have taken a pretty big bite out of things. Because if you think about what that would imply that not only has the price broken down below that purple line, and then it's come all the way down there, and then it's continued to go down. I mean, that would be a very nasty move to the downside. I'd be shocked if you're answering the question that the price is down below 8,300. But nonetheless, that is still an important level to consider going forward. Now, on the flip side of things, what about levels of resistance? So if you're answering that first question, well, Clay, the price is actually up above 8,800. The next question you would want to ask is, okay, well, where is the price at relative to 10,000, which is that red line right there. If you are answering the question that the price is up above that $10,000 mark, well then, as I've said in past videos, that's just where gut instincts comes into play, meaning if the price is slightly above 10,000, don't get me wrong, that's definitely a step in the right direction, but if the price is sitting up there at 10,500, well, at that point, that would be telling you that the bulls are having themselves a very nice, movement. So really, the higher the price is up above 10,000, the more and more bullish the chart actually is, the more strength that the price actually has. But if you're saying, well, Clay, the price is up above 8,800, but still down below 10,000, well, at that point, that's fine. Like I said, that just would be some sort of form of consolidation that's occurring, and there's nothing wrong with that at all. Sure, maybe not the most exciting thing, but consolidation at higher levels and up above areas of support is overall a healthy thing to have. So let's see what happens with this one going forward. First off, thanks so much for watching the entire video. Real quick, before you go, I want to invite you to a live webinar, web class, training, workshop, online event, whatever you want to call it, but it will be me live revealing to you what I discovered that has allowed me to transform myself from being an employee to being my own boss, including how I had only one losing day out of 73 days in total. I'm going to cover three keys that have helped me unlock profitable consistency within the markets. The first key is super weird, but in a productive type of way. The second key is super awesome because it quite literally is wired into our DNA as humans, making it very easy to use. But in a cruel way, this becomes a pitfall for many traders. I'll explain it all though, including how to avoid the pitfall that it creates for some. And yeah, the third key, when you hear it, sounds way too good to be true, but it's not, and I'll show you how it all works. Then at the end, I open it up for a question and answer session that is, again, totally live. Even if you can't make the live session, please still sign up as it will be recorded, and you can go back and watch the replay that I will send you. Click the image on the screen or click the link down in the description box so you can get the date and time and claim your spot, which I should note is limited due to the fact that this truly is a live event. If you have any questions, let me know. If not, I'll be seeing you soon.